Toby.
Welcome back to the show once again as we get into the week's topics. Let me see. Get that out of the way. Back to the meeting. Let's see. Back to the meeting. Google. Here we go. How a mother is balancing life in the pursuit of her dreams. An interview with actress Breyonna Thomas by Ajay, Tambe on Spotify, as well as Literally Is No Pressure, episode 154 with Peace. It is also on YouTube. The link is always below. Be sure to check those things out. And then I did want to say, send prayers to Crazy Bone from Bone Thugs and Harmony. That story just came out as I'm working on the show, that he's been rushed to the hospital and that he needs care. So prayers up to Crazy Bone right now as he got rushed to the hospital. Now, the story is, give us our money. Monique and Countessvaughn call out CBS yet again over unpaid royalties from their hit series, Theparkers. And then I must, like they said, Theparkers already a classic. Let's say it's based off of clips like this. Let me see if I get the sound going. And let me see that sound going. There we go.
Are you that Parker woman? Yeah. Damn, Jarrell sure could have done better. What are you talking about? You! Aren't you sort of old to be in college? Aren't you sort of old to be wearing that outfit? You know, you could go to jail for what you're doing. Look, I don't know why you're tripping, but if I do go to jail, it'll be for whipping your rude ass. Oh, come on.
So classic Parkers. So this is a timeless show. So that's back to what I'm saying when we talk about this story. And it's about how they feel once again, their deal with the company isn't giving them their fair share of the royalties. Nowadays, with the strike that's going on with the writers and the actors, it's very important that everybody get their coins. And for a show like The Parkers that was on every single time that you turned on the TV, it is no way, you know, that they should be shortchanging Monique now, because they know they got the money. They played that show so much. The show went from 1999 to 2004. This is not her first time she has broached renegotiation talks with CBS and Paramount regarding her unfair deal and unpaid royalties. She filed a lawsuit back in April against the companies, hoping to move their hand, and similar to show creators, which is Ralph Farquhar, Sarah Johnson, Beta Spears, who sued and settled in 2022. So obviously they were like, hey, we need to go up and try and get what's ours, just like the rest of everybody else did. Like the trio, the couple believes that CBS used questionable measures to inflate expenses and suppress profit payments on the show that ran for 5 seasons and produced more than 110 episodes. So now that they've settled out with that last group from the show, that should make it easier for Countess and Monique, because it's like, yo, y'all already done said that y'all DXYZ. We picking back right on the back of it. Where is the proper money that we deserve for this? Countess and I did a show called The Parkers. This is what Monique said. The Parkers has now been on the air for 24 years, and they're trying to convince us through our ownership that we made absolutely no money, and I just don't believe it. They played it too much. Another show, maybe you could sell me, and I'll sit here and be like, maybe they ain't play it like that. But The Parkers, they outplayed The Parkers like, hey, Professor Olivier, we know all the sayings, my G. Sydney asks, it baffles being that when you can have a conversation with the executives and they allude to the fact that the show in its entirety, 5 years, was made for under $70 million. The comedian and her husband claim that they were able to see profit participation statement that the show program made over $700 million. In 2009, they said the producers told them that the show was close to $1 billion or $1 billion in the red. And that's crazy. I don't see how a show that came out in 1999, going to the red when y'all are making the control over. Y'all already done paid who y'all gonna pay. Well, we're asking for CBS King of Treat. Please treat two black women fairly. And I think they should do it in any, they should do it overall. If the splits is not right, because like she put in here, when Dave Chappelle, and it's depending on how much people like you too, because people hate on Monique. You got some people that like Monique, some people that hate Monique. When Dave Chappelle came out and said that, you know, Netflix, and you know, I got a messed up deal. I have HBO and Max. HBO Max, they not paying me for the Chappelle show. I ain't getting the right cut of that. I signed a bad deal with Comedy Central back in the day, and they not paying me my rightful splits. Sure enough, they got it back right, and they got it back on the streaming sites once they got Dave Chappelle situated. I don't know what the settlement was, but he made enough hip hop, and everybody cared enough about him. They cared enough about him that they put up a stand for it. So they say, like they said, fans are saying, my mama and sister alone watch at least 100,000 worth of repeats. Pay the black women her worth. Mo ain't wrong, so don't y'all start. The Parkers with the show back then and still is today. Run them their money. They do gotta pay Monique now, man. This show was a classic. And they used to play all the time, different things. Hello, hey, y'all can't freeze on me like that, don't you? Yeah, man, that's a classic, man. Pay Monique now. Y'all let me know what y'all think about this. Like I said, today on streaming service, they play their episodes. Pay them folks the right share. Don't be giving them folks like 25 cents and then like get on their proper share. And let me know what y'all thoughts are on the story. Because like I said, Monique them is saying they're not getting a proper splits when it comes to the Parkers. Everybody and their mama and everybody mama specifically watch the Parkers over and over. It's more than enough money to pay them their proper share. I don't know what the splits are. So maybe the company looks at this and say, you little ungrateful mother. We done gave y'all X amount of dollars over the years. Don't y'all go to the public saying that y'all ain't getting y'all money right. But because they the big company, they ain't nobody from their end gonna come out and speak like that. They'll only be able to speak through court. But it could really be a situation where Monique never was like, yo, y'all haven't paid us our proper splits. Let me know what y'all thoughts are. Does Monique and Countess, and please forgive me if I'm getting her name wrong, deserve the bag? Or is it just like, nah, they've been probably paid right. They complaining about nothing. And there's nothing that company owed them. Y'all let me know what your thoughts are. It's the NYA show. And I appreciate y'all once again. Prayers up to Crazy Bone, who is in the hospital. Let's have a great week. I'll be right back with y'all later on this week to chop it up. And I appreciate y'all.